One of the biggest challenges we have in the century, maybe the biggest one, is how to feed ourselves 7 billion plus without wrecking the ecosystems that support that food supply in the first place. That big challenge is one of the reasons that we study bees and pollination. About 2/3 of the most important crops in the world require bees and other pollinators to produce the food we grow them for. Pollination is incredibly valuable to our farmers and to our societies and to our food supplies. It's worth billions of dollars every year. The problem is that a bunch of these pollinator populations and bee species are in decline, so we really need to figure out how to keep them healthy in our landscapes.
We're working with local farmers and we're working with them to study wild bees. And wild bees are our native species that are naturally occurring, given the right habitat. We're interested in which species pollinate what crops, as well as what sort of landscapes support bees, and how to accurately calculate how bees improve crop yield.
So what we really want to do with this research is help farmers understand how they can manage their land to not only conserve bees and other pollinators, but also do it in a way that helps them with their bottom line.
Some ways that have been shown to promote wild bees on farms are maintaining wildflower strips, delaying or limiting pesticide use, and general organic farming practices.
So what we're trying to do here, and in a lot of projects with collaborators around the world, is line up two things that aren't typically aligned, and that's economics and the conservation of nature. And if we can do that, if we can find ways to do both in the same landscapes, these working landscapes, then we have a chance of ensuring a sustainable food supply, but also conserving biodiversity in the natural world while we do it. Mm-hmm.